That's correct.
Okay.
She didn't really do her dances. She just went straight for it. She's so hungry.
I was hungry for it this morning. Yeah.
But. Whoa, careful. Okay. Alright.
Look at how long.
That's a lot.
Oh,
I remember our rule.
What happened?
Huh. Maybe somebody went in and fixed it. Even
that
though you didn't deserve it.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Whoa, that's way too much. That's so much.
Four gummies, five Skittles.
What the heck? How did she get more?
I had to move the Indies Mint from Christmas Day. Or Christmas Eve.
I just took it a bunch.
Oh!
That's a good question, Joshua. Didn't we talk? Hey, didn't we talk about yesterday that we wouldn't complain about calendar candy anymore? I'd throw it all away.
I'm just saying. I wonder how she got that much.
She got that much because I had to move the Indies Mint. Otherwise, it's the same. I had to move the Indies Mint from Christmas, and I told you I wasn't going to explain anymore about the candy.
Oh, she had to move the candy. So that's what.
It just looks like a lot.
These are my favorite candies. You swap them in, I know.
It looks like a lot because it's big.
Yeah, because the Nerds gummies.
Not that much.
Okay.
Nerd gummies.
They're your favorite,
nerds.
And I went and got them.
Megan, you're a nerd.
I'm eating nerds. I'm not a nerd.
Or you're a cannibal.
That's what I was going to say.
No, I mean like you're a real nerd, like you're... That person is a nerd.
That's okay.
Like the insult nerd.
Why are you saying that? I was a nerd too.
Avocado toast.
Oh no, we're all gonna die.
I'm gonna do an Ada.
Of course, as soon as the camera comes on, you get away from my avocado toast. Oh, I'm coming back. Had to make sure you were safe. No! Stop! Hello, avocado toast.
No.
I'm being awfully beanie today. Good morning, everybody. So I'm going to work on the kids' pajama pants right now. It is 8:16 a.m. Time check. Got them all cut out. I think I'm gonna start with Joshua's because kids are smaller. I don't know. Feels like they're gonna be easier. I think I have a normal needle on here. Not really sure, to be honest. I might not. I might still have my upholstery needle on here. I feel like I maybe have my upholstery needle on here. because I think I was fixing the dog leash was the last sewing project I was doing. I also don't have my sewing machine plugged in, so I'm gonna need to do that. And I can't read this. One, ten, something. Okay. I think. Yeah. Because these are 110s and I can see there's a 110, so it's probably a 110-18. That's what was in there. The last thing I was planning on working on after the leash was my cushion covers, and those I would have needed an upholstery needle for. But I need a normal needle, so I'm going to get that, and then I'm going to get my tripod so I don't have to sit here and hold the camera. And then I'm going to get started on sewing stuff. And then I'll take a shower, because that would be good. Thank you. see how far I can go here.
Should be able to go further than that. No?
Okay. Time check, 10:37. Pants are done, other than putting elastic in the waist and hemming, which I need my children for. I have my box of elastic there, so I need to figure out which size fits in there. And I am now going to go and take a shower, and then I will start on the peppermint pie. Are you celebrating?
Yep.
In case you didn't know, everyone, it's International Squat Rack Maintenance Day. Take care of your squat rack.
Yeah, I haven't gotten too much done yet. I was cleaning all the bad powder coat off of these.
Oh, yeah.
So I had to scratch it and oil it and clean it. And then these guys that came with my curl bar, I had to show you the bad one. See, it was very corroded.
Not now.
So, but now it's brushed in oil. I mean, it's just a crappy gal job. You know, I got it for like $50 online, right?
Mm-hmm. I'm clean. Anyway, my shower's done. I just threw my hair into little side buns because I'm going to be making pie and I don't want my hair down. I'm wearing my Sperry sweater that is in Bull and Vine Yarns and Plies and Hellhounds, Hell Devil. An order came from a new maker to me. This is really hard. Like, got my tripod, but I'm holding it weird. I didn't make it into the selfie stick. Anyway, on Instagram, I follow Black Makers Matter. It's a really, really great account, and they, you know, give links and like a bio and what inspired that person to start their business. And I've found a lot of great things from there. I found KMD candles. I found, See, now I'm gonna go look. The lotion and body, Divinity Body Care. And she's in, Las Vegas. Anyway, so this was a new candle maker, Naked Wick Candles. So she makes luxury soy wax candles. And so I got a couple just to try them out because I like that they come in these really nice glass jars. So this one is very vanilla. And then the other one I got is coconut. So two good basic scents that are they're good year round. I really like coconut candles in the summertime, but they're scents that could be year round. So Naked Wick Candles, very nice. She even sent me a note that her shipping was gonna be a little bit delayed. She even has cute, let's see if I can do this while showing you my address. Custom packing tape. Super cute. So anyway, those are nice. So I'm going to put those in my craft room because I'm always burning a candle, especially when I'm working from home. It's kind of part of my going into my office ritual is I pick what candle I'm going to burn for the day. I change my calendar over to the current day. I check my plants and then I start working. So keep having a thing with my, like little pieces of mascara keep coming off. Anyway, I finally finished a blush stick, so I had to start a new one. I also have this strange place on my cheek where like nothing, no pigment will stay. I didn't used to have it. And I used this, cream that was a brightening cream, and it bleached my skin right there. And it's been that way for 2 years now, and it will not regain pigment. So I think I've permanently, like, scarred myself there to have this white streak. So, whatever. Caution when using said products. Yeah, it was one of those that has, like, the hyaluronic acid that's supposed to be, like, a skin brightener, but it's fine. Like, I only use natural products now, so I'll just have one bleachy spot on my skin forever. I'm eating a few sugar cookie M&Ms, but I should make some lunch because it's 11:50. Time check, 11:50. So the kids are going to be home really soon. That's why Josh is doing his squat rack. The two things I want to make today are the dough for the candy cane shortbread cookies and the peppermint pie. So I decreamed all the Oreos last night. I brought up the whipped cream. I had the children peel all of my peppermints, so I need to bring those in. I'm gonna have to crush them, but I can crush them while the middle is cooking. So this bucket is all de-plasticed now. I also got a box of pretzels from work. The VP of my division got all of his leadership team like these pretzel medleys. So it's a ton of like soft pretzels, different shapes and sizes and stuff. And then it has either salt or like a sweet sprinkles to put on them. So I think what we're going to do is like one day we'll have soft pretzels for dinner and just kind of, you know, do a fun family thing with some dips and stuff. Maybe Christmas Eve. So it's not too much work. Okay. Oh God. I'm gonna put my recipe box back in here half open. My recipe box. I got it from the thrift store in Reynoldsburg. So it has equivalent measurements on here. And then on the top, it's got this little slot. You can see it right there by my nose. You can put your recipe card in that while you're baking, and it will sit straight, which is a very nice feature. So I'm pretty sure that I wrote the peppermint pie down on a thing, but now I have to find it. Counter needs to be seriously cleaned off. There's an open package of Ritz crackers from the kids. Like, why were you holding it, Miss Gina? You could have just done this a while ago. Don't ask me, I don't make sense. Okay, put that up there. All right. Now I gotta try to find the thing. My marshmallows recipe. I haven't made marshmallows in a couple of years because my thing was broken. Okay, here we go. I did do my cream cheese sugar cookies. I wrote it out so that if I lost the book. And then here's the candy cane cookies. And here is the peppermint pie. So peppermint pie has a lot of steps. It's got the crust, which we'll make first. It's got the filling. And then it has the topping, which is really whipped cream. So you need two containers of whipped cream. This is really weird seeing it all backwards. It'll get flipped around. Anyway, Yeah, 2 cups of heavy whipping cream for the filling and then a cup for the topping. It is not in any way, shape, or form a healthy pie. Don't go there if you want to eat this pie. This is the instructions for how to bake it. So you're just going to bake the crust at 350 until it's crispy. Then let it cool. And the filling, you're going to cook it on the stove. And then you're going to let it sit up in the fridge for 2 hours. And then you can put the topping on. So we're going to get done with the crust and we're going to make the filling. We're probably not, well, we're definitely not going to have the topping done before the kids go home because it has to chill for 2 hours. So that's what we're going to do. And then the Candy King cookies, I have out 2 sticks of butter and that's cracked. So it's a cup of butter. I was just guessing there. Cup of powdered sugar, 1 egg. 1 teaspoon vanilla extract, 1 teaspoon of peppermint extract, 3 cups of flour, 1/2 teaspoon salt, and of course, your food coloring. I need to see what color food coloring we have. We may not have any red. I don't think we do. I have to do green. Whatever. They're still delicious. Okay. I'm gonna put the rest of my stuff away. And then also for dinner tonight, we are going to have the butternut squash vegan mac and cheese / pasta bake. It's really yummy. We baked the butternut squash 2 days ago and Josh remembered to blanch the cashews. So those are blanching. So yeah. Let's make some pie. Taking a food break. I made some eggs with cheese and spinach. Yeah, just cheese and spinach. Then I'm doing breakfast sausages. I have 1 more half of pita, having some more coffee. It's almost time for the kids to come home. The crust is out and it is cooling. And then I have some dishes on the stove to do. I also need to reload the dishwasher. Get this counter cleared off for cookies later and then put away the dishes. So I'm trying to do dishes as I'm going, which is making this take a little longer, but the cleanup at the end won't be as bad. So I put away the food processor already. I washed the food processor stuff. I just need to wash the blade to put it away, but this piece should be dry when I'm done eating, and I can put that away. By then, the crust should be cool. The gelatin is setting up right now. And then I'm going to crush some peppermints somehow. We figure it out every year. I think we usually take a cookie sheet outside, put them in a baggie, and hit them with a hammer. That's probably what we're going to do. Butter, not whipped cream. Ready to start again.